Good evening to you all. I'm Martin Logan and welcome to the Irish in the UK. And well done to Henry for the Irish at Home and Abroad show. Here's what's coming up this evening. We're at a Driscoll's Irish Bar in Manchester. We'll be attending great celebrations in Liverpool. Nathan Carter will be singing a song for us. But first up, we went along to the Rochdale Town Hall on St Patrick's Day to join the Mayor and Mayoress of Rochdale, Tony Lloyd MP, and many more to raise the tricolour in all its glory over the Rochdale Town Hall. Mayor, it's a very special day for the Irish here in Rochdale.
Yes, it's a very special day for Rochdalians too. I think we've all got a bit of Irish in us here.
And it was lovely to see the tricolour lifted there earlier on. It's getting a great blowing out there in the wind.
Yes, it is. It is blowing all right. It should be rain really on St Patrick's Day, but we're doing our best. It's sunshine now, but windy.
Now, you spoke there about your ancestry, going back many years, of course, but you've got links with Ireland.
Yes, my maternal grandmother, my mother's mother, came from County Mayo. Mary Avey, I think it was, but as I said before, they're a bit liberal in the spelling in those days, so it might have been Avery, I'm not sure. If anybody out there knows, please let me know.
And Lady Mayor, of course, there's a lot of Irish community here in Rochdale.
Yes, and we've come across a lot of people, especially the children from St Patrick's, who have really done us proud today by singing. They've come to one or two of our events and they've been brilliant, yeah. And lots of friends of ours are Irish, you know, and are very proud to be Irish too.
Yeah. And a great turnout here at the Rochdale Town Hall this morning.
Oh, it is, yes, especially as the weather was absolutely dreadful first thing, but luckily the sun's shining now, so it's been lovely, yes, yeah. Very nice community spirit.
The best slide of rights, we had 2 million barrels of sand. In bales of old man eagle's tails, we had 4 million barrels of bones.
Tony, a special morning to be here in Rochdale, of course, with the Irish community. What does it mean to you to be Irish?
Well, it means an awful lot because it's part of my identity growing up, you know, and I'm very proud of that. You don't cut off one side of your background, do you? And, of course, like everything, you know, the Irish have been working, living and been part of the community here in Rochdale for now the best part of 200 years coming up since the days of the famine drove people out. And even before that, of course, because industrialisation created the jobs that brought people over, there's people who don't even know they've got Irish ancestry living in this town. But, of course, the good thing is, you know, there was a time when I was a child when being Irish wasn't always the most fashionable thing to be. I think these days, young people and not so young people, everyone, if they can claim that little tricolour in the corner of their eye, they're happy to do it. Happy to say yes, me mother, me grandfather, me great great grandmother on me dad's side was from Kerry, Cork, Armagh, or Donegal. And of course, that's great because the situation between our two islands now is a great thing. The only, just one sore thing, of course, at the moment, the whole Brexit thing. is making life difficult, because the biggest issue is still going to be to make sure we have no border between north and south, and that's what I look forward to seeing as a result of that. So on this happy St. Patrick's Day, let's be optimistic about the future. Let's be optimistic about the millions of Irish people who've made this country, this our country together, our two countries working together in a such great part of the world.
And you've got a lovely piece of shamrock there, Tony, as well.
Well, you know, I just hope I can defy the odds and make sure this little bit of Ireland can grow in my home. Of course, it's traditionally not supposed to be able to grow well outside of Ireland, but let's hope that my mother's family smile down on me and say, this little bit of Ireland can grow in this pot, and we'll see the shamrock flourish.
That's a lovely celebration here at Rochdale Town Hall this morning.
It was indeed. Better than the weather. It was really good. These have been going for a number of years. They'd say that was the best turnout ever, although I think some people are here for the railway exhibition. But there was a really good turnout. It's been going on a number of years, like I say. A lovely man from Kells in County Meath, I think, as far as I know, set up the tradition, a man by the name of Patsy Maguire. And he did it for a number of years, and then his health wasn't too good, so he asked me if I would take it on. And reluctantly, I said, all right. I said, I don't know what to do, really, but anyway, we did. And we're carrying on 3 or 4 years now, maybe, and building up all the time and getting more people involved.
Well, it was great to see music and dancing and singing here today, and what a lovely morning.
Well, we were blessed with the music and the dancing. We never thought of Christine coming in. She was still there, but she'd been dancing last night, of course, till 2 o'clock this morning. And it was great to have her here, and it gives me ideas for next year. She won't be on her own next year. We'll have a troupe of them, the cone of day, and the music, and we're going to build on that as well. And plenty of singers and recitations, you know. And of course, we get great support from the council. They've really done us proud. And Dorothy, the Mayor's Secretary, looks after us very well.
On a bitterly cold St. Patrick's morning, it was great to see such wonderful celebrations. Now, Booker's Plantire has been supporting the Manchester Festival for many years, and recently they took some of their customers and friends along to our Driscoll's Bar to celebrate the festival. He said the weather could be better.
Down here at Old Driscoll's Bar, we've got a great band on and we're all having a fantastic time.
And we've got loads of your machines here all around Albert Square. Are you going to do any digging tonight?
Well, I won't be doing any digging tonight, but I can tell you now they're all available for immediate hire tomorrow.
Very good. Now, you've been a great supporter, of course, of the Irish Festival, and you know, we've seen the parade last week going on and everything, and it's good to see the company involved.
Yes, I'm very proud to be stood here tonight as the Managing Director of Booker's Plantire. Our roots go back many, many years. We've been involved in the Irish Festival now for over 25 years.
Now, Michael, you're the commercial manager for Booker's. How does that job work out for you?
Yeah, it's as it stays, it's challenging, but, you know, I'm here to save the company money, so, yeah, good.
Well, somebody's got to save the company money, and it's really, really important, of course, that money is tight, so you've got to get the machinery out there, but still you've got to look after the pennies.
Absolutely, that's what I'm here for, to save John as much money as we can.
Well, absolutely. Now, Mark, your operations director, tell me a little bit about your job.
I look after the 4 depots that we've got within the company, as well as the specialist and all the transport and everything else we've got going on.
So, So you must do quite a lot of travelling, because I know your depots you've got up in Scotland, you're here in Manchester.
Yes, that's correct. Yeah, we've got a depot in Aberdeen, depot in Bathgate, Leeds and Manchester. So it's mine and Paul's responsibility to make sure that we make sure all machines are utilised and hired out every single day.
Well, that's a very important job for the company, because that's the lifeblood, of course, getting the machines out there on hire.
Of course it is, but we have a fantastic team, fantastic company to work for, and we all work well together to make sure it happens every single day.
That's really good, and it's good to look after your customers as well.
Fantastic customers, and as you can tell tonight, all the customers are here and it's been absolutely brilliant so far.
Absolutely. Now, Paul, of course, you had a night here for your customers and your friends and family and everybody here at O'Driscoll's Bar. I'm sure they all enjoyed it.
Absolutely, and it just sums up what the Buckhurst family is all about. We're a family-based company based in Rosendale. We're obviously focused on what is family traditional values. We're a company that invests in people, they invest in us, and for us, the future is very, very bright.
Now, if people wanted to hire your machinery, how can they get in contact with you?
Well, many ways, really. We've got our Facebook site where they can message us from, obviously email, our website, and obviously they can contact all of our depots via phone.
Well, they all seem to have a great time, and well done to Buckhurst Plantire for supporting the Irish community here in Manchester. Now we're off for a quick break. Welcome back to the show. Now, Irish Community Care in Liverpool does wonderful work for the community, and recently we went along to St Anne's Club in the Wirral to meet them all.
Irish group started over nearly 20 years ago in July. It's 20 years old, and I first joined it about 18 and a half years ago.
Well, you've done wonderful work to keep it going all those years.
Well, we didn't think it would last that long, but we've been in three different places: St. Werburgh's, St. Lawrence's, and now St. Anne's in Rockferry.
How strong is the Irish community out here in the Wirral?
It's quite strong, but there isn't a lot for the Irish over here, so we do try to keep it, and this is why we are still going, because a lot of people are still interested in the Irish music and the Irish community.
And Anne, of course, there's a great crowd here. They're all celebrating St. Patrick's Day and the big celebrations coming up the weekend.
Oh yes, we do that every year, and it's always a very successful event. People love it. They love the Irish dancing, Irish music, chat, get together. Some just come for a little talk, maybe the only people he talked to all week. So it's a good community.
Now tell me, how did you two girls meet?
Right, we met originally about 20 years ago. I used to go over to the old Irish Centre and Anne would be around there. But we've been great friends for about 12, 13 years when Nathan was brought into the club to sing for us. So it was a wonderful thing. He got up on the stage when he was about 10, used to come when he was off school, and then when he was 15 he asked me could he have a booking. So we finally gave him a booking and he got a regular booking after that.
Well, that's great. Now Nan, of course, we know that you're both very famous, of course, for supporting Nathan Carter, and I believe you've just come back from a great weekend in Blackpool.
Oh, it was fantastic, really. The whole set up, music, dance, everyone loved it. I think most people have booked for next year already. They loved it.
Being his nan, you must be so proud of both Nathan and Jake, because of course Jake is doing really well with the dancing.
Oh yeah, we're going over to see him. He's absolutely wonderful. I didn't know he could dance. I knew he could jive, but I didn't know he could actually dance. So we're so proud of him, and so is Nathan. He really is so proud of him.
Carol, of course, you've done a lot of travelling with Nan here to promote Nathan, haven't you?
I certainly have. I've been all over the place. We've gone to Ireland three or four times a year. and we also go away to Spain for a week with Nathan. And we've just done Blackpool, as you've said, we've just done Blackpool, wonderful weekend, and I love every minute of it. Yeah. Love it.
Absolutely. Now, getting back here today to the group that you've got here, yeah, going for 20 years, let's say, this is a lovely club that you've got here now, isn't it?
It's very well supported, and we keep going, and they only have to pay a couple of pounds coming in, and they get all these parties, and we get two trips a year for nothing, and they also get two parties for nothing, St. Patrick's Day party and a Christmas Day party. So we get two parties and two trips out of what they bring in each week. Just by paying £2, and they also get fed each week.
Nicky, we're having a great day here, of course, with the Whittle Group. Are you enjoying it? And you've got them all up there dancing on the floor.
It's great. It's great to be here with them all, like seeing them enjoying themselves for the St. Patrick's Day celebrations. Yeah, it's great.
Of course, this is always a busy time for you, and we know that you just finished your weekend in Blackpool. How did that go for you?
Do you know, it was great. It was the 10th year this year, and it's more popular than ever now. More so that we've put one on in June 1st, 2nd and 3rd at the same place, and we have Stephen Smith out for two nights. We have a whole rake of acts from Ireland over at it, yeah.
So how can people book their tickets for that one, Nicky?
Well, they could contact me on my phone number, yeah, 07796133280. Or they can email me it's nicky@njamesmusic.co.uk.
Now, tell us, how is things going for you in general?
Well, I'm pleased because I'm busy most of the time, and it's great, you know, and I'm very lucky and blessed to be able to do it. And, you know, I enjoy it. It's great to be paid for something that you'd love doing and you'd do for nothing anyway. So, yeah, I'm very lucky.
And you get a lot of bookings as well in Ireland. You're across the Irish Sea quite a bit, aren't you?
I do. I go probably once every six, 7 weeks I'm over there, yeah, and play around local, around my home place, South Armagh, around there. But I played a few festivals as well, along with doing Nathan's thing in Killarney in May time. And I'm over there with the Charlie Pride's in the end of June. So I'll be with Ryan Turner, the band, with that, and yeah.
Coming back to today, Nicky, of course, it's great to see the community here being looked after so well with food and music and everything. They're really enjoying themselves.
Absolutely. And this was started a few years ago by a great man for the Irish community. Did a lot. Sadly, he's in a home now, but he was called Phil Farley. He used to run the Irish Centre in Liverpool for many, many years. And he was a great, great man who'd done lots of stuff for the Irish community around the whole of Liverpool and the Merseyside area.
I've been working for Irish Community Care the privilege of working for Irish Community Care for 14 years. And we work in Liverpool, the North West, Wigan, Cheshire and Wirral. Over the 14 years of myself, I've been basically the Wirral worker, but we've had a restructure and I work across the whole, all the areas. We work with anyone that's Irish, Irish descent, travelling communities, anyone that's homeless, alcohol, drugs, mental health, isolation and benefits. Basically we support them in any way and form that they need. And we don't have a time scale to work with them, we work with them as long as they need us to support.
That's fantastic work that you're doing to support the Irish community here in Liverpool. Now Linda, tell me a little bit about your role.
I do administration in the office, so I coordinate the policies. We have a lot of policies requested for by our funders, so we make sure that our policies are robust and fit for purpose. I sort archiving of files when we're no longer in contact with service users. I'm also at the moment looking at the changes to the Data Protection Act and how that will affect the charity. And normal reception and any other admin duties that come our way.
Now, Ruth, you're a new recruit. Tell me a little bit about your role here with Irish Community Care.
Well, I'm a student social worker at Liverpool Hope, so I'm working with Irish Community Care and they're just basically teaching me everything from scratch. This is my first placement out in the field, so I'm doing support work, and so I'm shadowing Julie and all the other team. I just kind of follow what they're doing and learn by watching and by following. So I do drop in with Julie, but we do it separately, so I'll learn my personal skills and social work skills through working with them.
Are you enjoying it?
I love it because it's not specialised. I like the fact that they work with everyone, because a lot of placements will just be with one type or one vulnerable type of people, whereas like I get to work with absolutely everyone, so it's good experience.
Well done to Anne, Carol and everybody involved with Irish Community Care in Liverpool for the wonderful work they all do. And it's only fitting that we finish the show tonight with Anne's grandson singing a lovely song for us. Of course, that's Nathan Carter. Now, I hope you've enjoyed the show tonight. Don't forget, Henry McGlade is back next Thursday evening at 7 o'clock with the Irish at Home and Abroad. And I'm back at 7:30 with the Irish in the UK. Both shows are repeated on a Saturday evening between 8 and 9 p.m. Until next week, here's Nathan.
Good time girls, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight, come out tonight. Good time girls, won't you come out tonight? We'll dance by the light of the moon. Hey! As I was walking down the street, down the street, down the street, a pretty little girl I chanced to meet. We danced by the light of the moon. You know I danced with a dolly with a hole in a sock and her knees kept knocking. Band was rocking. I danced with a dolly with a hole in a stocking. We danced by the light of the moon. Saying good time girls, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight, come out tonight. Good time girls, won't you come out tonight? We'll